with Maxim Vlasov with for me the main event, and it's gonna be the main event of this fight. Questions about your preparation for Glowacki. Glowacki is known as a guy who is very unconventional southpaw, just like you, with the different style, because it's hard to predict what he's gonna do. What will be your tactics to nullify his strengths?
Ну, естественно, подготовка под левшу, она отличается кардинально от подготовки к ортодоксу, ну, к сопернику, который работает в ортодоксальной стойке. И, естественно, совершенно, ну, меняются совершенно углы атаки, углы защиты, и поэтому, ну, естественно, все иначе. В этом моменте мне повезло, потому что тренер у меня левша и боксировал как левша, и поэтому он знает, что делать именно против левшей.
I will need you to translate.
Sure.
Thank you, sir.
Sure. So preparing for a fight against southpaw versus an orthodox fighter is fundamentally different. You need to change everything from your angle of attack, your angle of defense. Thankfully, I have a coach that is also southpaw and has fought against other southpaw, so he's very experienced in that, and he's helping me prepare properly.
The common knowledge will say that you will have advantage if the fight is going to be in the middle of the ring. He will have advantage if he will be able to push you on the ropes, keep you in the corners. Do you agree?
Обычно как бы скажут, что если вы будете держать, бой будет в середине ринга, то будет у вас преимущество. Если он вас в углу заведет прессовать, то преимущество будет у него. Вы с этим согласны? Я согласен.
Абсолютно согласен и абсолютно уверен, что ни в коем случае мне нельзя идти назад и канатом. Поэтому я буду стремиться забирать инициативу и чтобы центр ринга всегда был за моей спиной.
I agree absolutely. I think that it's imperative that I stay in the middle of the ring and not back away, not back up towards the ropes or towards the corners. So I will be looking to always take initiative and keep the fight in the middle.
What the people don't know about you? I'm talking not the private life, but as a boxer. When people are talking Maxim Vlasov, what they are not seeing watching you as a fighter? Because you are not very well-known boxer. I know you. I saw you in Russia a couple of times when you fought live, when I was there covering events. But people in the United States, what they have to know about you as a fighter? Something that you think people are overlooking?
No, вообще так повелось, что многие не понимают мой стиль бокса и не принимают его, то есть не могут его правильно оценить. И я думаю, что вот именно это они не знают обо мне, что у меня отличный техничный стиль бокса и много очень мелочей и вещей, которые незаметны глазу. И вот хотел бы, чтобы обратили люди именно вот на мелочи в технике и тактике бокса.
I think that it's just the way it is that most people don't understand, don't accept, and as a result don't appreciate my style of boxing, and they don't notice the little details that I do and all the little technical things that I excel at. I think I have excellent technical skills. So these are the things that I would urge people to look at and recognize.
The last question, I appreciate your time, Maxim. First of all, there's a long line of great Russian cruiserweights. There's a lot of them. The world champions, Drost, a lot of them. Kudryashov, great fighters. What do you see yourself right now? If you make top 10, top 5 of the best Russian cruiserweights? Tough one. Be honest.
Провокационный политический вопрос. На мой взгляд, да, конечно, те боксеры, которых вы перечислили, те крузера, которых вы сказали, да, может быть, по каким-то регалиям, там, по титулам, они стоят выше меня. Но в плане техники, тактики, интереса, как боксера, я считаю, что гораздо выше их всех.
So, first of all, it's a provocative question that you asked me.
I appreciate it answering.
So, all the names that you've mentioned, they are great boxers indeed, and if you count only their accomplishments that they have achieved, then perhaps they have achieved more than I have thus far. But if you look at my technical skills, my the interest of me as a boxer, I think I surpass all of them.
I said the last one, but I was lying. This is really the last one. There is an opinion that it's gonna be Wovatsky, it's gonna be Dortykas, Brady's, or you. So basically, there's 8 fighters. But the common knowledge, I mean, and the common opinion is, you are one of the top 4 best fighters in this tournament right now. So you think that the Głowacki is, for example, better than Brady's, or is he better than Dortykas, or you don't think this way?
Я думаю, что в принципе соперники подобраны так, что практически все равны. Ну, как бы у каждого свой стиль бокса, свои недостатки и свои преимущества, но все примерно равны. Единственное, как я уже говорил неоднократно, что, на мой взгляд, пара Брейди с Гевором не совсем равноценная. Брейди гораздо выше уровнем.
I think that the fighters were picked in a way that actually they're all evenly matched for the most part. Everyone has their own advantages and shortcomings, but altogether they're evenly matched. The only exception in my mind is Brady's versus Gior. I think Brady is a far better fighter.
I agree, by the way. Thank you very much. I appreciate the time, and let the best man win, always.